Hey, this is ANdyReacts from Germany. That's where the accent comes from. And I'm about to watch the last episode of Amphibia, and I don't know how to feel about this. Yeah, it's called the hardest thing. What's the hardest thing? I think the hardest thing is not hard to figure out. The hardest thing is to say goodbye forever. That's what I think is about to happen in this episode. I think that the planters, especially Sprig and Anne, have to say goodbye forever to each other, and that their worlds will never be able to collide again, or that it won't be able to journey from one world to the other, and there will be a complete cut and dead set, and their story together will end. And this feels so sad for me just to think about it, but I'm pretty sure this is what's about to happen, because it was a bit foreshadowed in the last episode when Sprig was like, oh yeah, she's always gonna be in my life, and Hop-Up was like, oh, something's changed, and I was like, oh god, no. I always wished for an ending where the planters could visit Earth and the Bun Choice and the girls could visit Amphibia whenever they want with a secret dimension portal or something. But I guess this is not what I'm gonna get. I really thought for some time that this was gonna be the end of Amphibia, that there would be a possibility for, you know, traveling to the other dimension, because Amphibia was so lighthearted. But it got a bit dark lately, very dark even, and it fits more that there is a complete cut, actually. And it makes me sad. Also, it makes me sad that this is the last episode of Amphibia, and those characters have grown dear to my heart, and I don't want to say goodbye to them, and I know that I will have to. After these 30 minutes or so, it's over. It's done. I didn't want to start the last episode, but I don't want to start this episode even more.
Oh god.
Is there anything to say before I start? Predictions. Nice, heartfelt goodbyes, at least. That's all that I have right now. Can't think of something else. Andrew's not dying. I kind of like him. I sympathize with him, even though he's partly a dick. But I think it's set in stone that he will sacrifice himself in this last chapter, because otherwise, how would we deal with him after all that happened? It's kind of hard. A bit too hard for Disney, maybe. So I don't think he will survive. I love this family, I really do, and all the characters. When I saw the very first picture of Amphibia that came out back in 2019 or something like that, showed us what's about to come, what kind of series will come, I immediately knew I would love the series. I had no idea how it would actually be, but I loved this picture so much that I was sure it would become one of my favorite series. I was very sure that I would like it much more than the Owl House. The promo picture of the Owl House, the very first one, I didn't like as much. I now have to say that I like them both equally, you could say. Sometimes I like the Owl House a bit more, sometimes I like Amphibia a bit more. Today, definitely Amphibia. I still remember being in the hospital and there having to react to the very first episode. That was kind of awkward. But I was alone in a room and it was okay. I get nostalgic, and it was only 2 years ago or so. Or three, anyways. Oh yeah, good times. Let's do this. Let's watch the last episode of Amphibia. 3, 2, 1, go! Amphibia, the last episode. There's the core. What's its plan? Oh. The moon is a freaking machine? The fuck?
A plan to eradicate all life as we know it.
By what the hell?
Into Amphibia's surface.
Ooh.
It's afraid of being destroyed, of being out of it.
Okay, so it destroys everything itself? Ooh! Oh, Mother Ohm! She's here to help!
It said that the three of us would save the world.
Okay. So, yeah!
The prophecy doesn't necessarily say you'll succeed.
Huh? Come again?
The prophecy isn't so much a prediction as it is a humble request for help. You
know this. There might not be enough energy left for us to get home.
What?
We're stuck in Amphibia forever.
Oh, shit!
Yeah, so,
of course we'll help! There's
okay. No way. Then say goodbye to your parents and friends on Earth.
Don't forget about the secret spell.
Wait, the secret what now?
Huh?
Summoning such power
comes at a price.
Oh, losing your life?
The life of the user.
Ooh.
But hopefully it will never come to that.
Am I right? Yeah, thank you for saying that right now. Because that's fucking foreshadowing.
Think of your
memories of Amphibia.
Oh.
How much this world means to you.
Oh. This I could do the same. I love Amphibia. Ooh. Ooh. Warriors. Ooh, shit. Oh, God. They all have their anime powers now. Ooh. Oh, God. This is getting super duper over the top. It even sounds like an anime. In Germany, we say anime. I think you say anime, right? The fuck? Kind of said that this only happens in a very last episode, you know, the other two getting their powers and using them. What is happening? What can you do?
Most anime thing that's ever
happened. Yeah, anime, it's anime. You say anime. Okay. Dice? Yeah, 20. I play RPGs too. Ooh, yeah! Oh no. No! Darth Vader, come on, help me, I'm the Engage. What? No! Why?
Finally doing something useful.
You're helping! Oh! Oh! Yes! Yes! Yes!
Standing up to you!
Yeah! Oh, I was really thinking he would do something bad again. It's too strong. Of course it is. We need to use the fucking spell.
I know what we have to do.
Oh no.
To call upon the power of all three stones.
Oh shit.
I may die in the process.
She said she may not make it.
Oh.
What? Spring, no! It's too dangerous!
Yeah, oh god. Yeah, again, he has to do that. It's his friend.
These stones are not Amphibia's greatest treasure.
Oh, oh.
Mother Olm, can you help me see the world I love?
Oh. Oh no!
You changed my life.
Will she actually die?
And you've changed mine.
Oh. Oh no. Oh god. Oh shit! Yay! Wow. You're smiling, I would be sad.
It's okay.
Uh-huh.
Saving this world was the best decision I've ever made. My only regret is that I never got to see Love Joyce too.
Fuck. No, what the hell? It was a dream? Where are we? Huh? Another trick from the core?
Cosmic Guardian who has watched over countless worlds for countless eons. Whoa.
The hell? Kinda.
You're off by a couple decades.
How's this?
The better? Fuck?
Am I dead or something?
Huh?
Yes and no. I made a copy of you right before you expired. A
what?
Backup, if you will. For all intents.
A copy?
Purposes, you're the same Ann Boonchoy.
Well, clone. Some serious existential dread later on.
Yep.
Just to watch your viewer.
Lovecraft would approve.
I want to offer you a job.
Huh?
What?
It's exhausting.
So you want a successor?
You would consider being my replacement.
Yeah.
Me? I'm gonna have to pass.
I haven't even told you about Big on Fridays.
Sorry.
And Taco Tuesdays?
Probably blow up the multiverse if you put me in charge.
You don't know about that.
My time in Amphibia taught me that we're all changing and improving and learning as we go.
So you're saying you could continue improving? Maybe even one day feel worthy of this post?
What? Oh god, the thing really wants her to be hers or their successor.
About that.
What's happening?
I'm sending you back to the world of the living.
Ooh, so you might come back and get the job.
Live your life. I've waited thousands of years to retire. What's 78 years more?
78.
Are you saying that in 78 years I'm gonna...
Pretty much, yes. Ouch! What the hell was that? My brain is about to explode.
Not now, Anne. We're mourning the loss of a true hero. The greatest kid who ever...
Yay! Hawk time! Yeah! Not the stones.
What are those? They're a chance for a fresh start.
Yeah. Oh,
I think they're one-time use only.
One time? No! Oh, here we go! Ah, fuck!
There's no coming back.
Ugh.
Not only that, I wish I'd gotten to know you both better.
No.
You help
helped us see what was important as well.
Oh, ah, oh, they are a couple. Goodbye, come on, Andreas. Give him a hug.
Take care, kiddo.
Oh, Lord.
Commander.
Lieutenant.
Hug time. Hug time. Come on. Oh, ugly crying for the win. Okay, okay, stop.
You're the little sister I never knew I needed.
Aww.
I know you're going to grow into an amazing frog and take over the world.
Yeah, please don't.
Thanks for taking me in. I'm so lucky to call myself a planter.
Oh.
I'm the lucky one, Anne. I'm so blessed to have a granddaughter like you.
Oh.
If you ever need a...
Goodbye, Anne.
Oh.
I'll never forget you. Spran against the world.
Yes, spran against the world.
I want you to have this. Maybe it'll help you on your future adventures.
Aww. Cool. Aw, saddest ending ever. I mean, with Anne being dead, it would have been even more sad, but still. So Andreas lives. Wow. Oh. 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 No. What? No! Oh. Just stick that thing into my heart, yeah, okay? And kill me! Your first hair? Yay.
I just got my first hair!
Sorry, Polly, but the legs were more exciting. Serving your time? Yeah, that's the right decision. Maybe someday they'll be able to forgive you. Ooh, what? Is this in the future? Oh god! Oh my god, it's Polly! She's a young teen! Hey, what happened to you? Why are you back to your old self?
Taking that cheat day.
Oh, more like cheat, yeah. Oh my god, yeah, they're becoming a couple. They're getting married, I guess. Rocking that beard! Cool grime. You're the mayor! Oh, what, really? I chip it. Yeah. We get it. Yeah, you! It's so great that they actually get together. Oh, yeah, wow. I love that they're a couple too. Oh, you look great, Sprig. I love your look. They both look adorable. Woo! Yeah, cool! Hmm? Ah, your girlfriend.
Discovered a new continent. Feel like a new adventure?
Of course. With her always.
I'm in.
Such a heartfelt ending. 10 years later. Oh. Hey! Looking good there. Cool. God, they've grown up so much. It's a bit weird.
Still doing that webcomic? I read a few chapters.
Webcomic? Oh, that's cool. So she's bound to be an artist. Of course, that makes sense.
I like working with the kids. Helping them overcome
kids?
Their emotional baggage. I have a lot of experience.
Yeah, that's true.
We kind of fell into different friend groups in high school.
Oh no. So you didn't become a couple, Sasha and Anne? Ugh, I'm disappointed. That is a future place?
Environment is everything.
Why not? Hi, little Sprig.
I named him Sprig.
Yeah.
Dear.
Ah, hi Anne. Okay, interesting future. Why not?
Change can be difficult, but it's how we grow.
Yeah.
It can be the hardest thing to realize you can't hold on to something forever.
The hardest thing, yes.
You have to let it go.
Oh.
You'd be surprised what makes its way back to you.
Yeah. Get lost in Amphibia. Oh god, she called it the place Amphibia. So they will probably never see each other again. Mother almost Whoopi Goldberg? I had no idea about that. Cool. Oh, this is from the very first season, the ending. Oh. Goodbye, Amphibia. Aww. So, it was a very nice last episode. It felt a tad rushed because Moon, fight, sacrifice, whatever the thing after that was. Goodbye. Ending. I mean, the ending itself, the ending after the fight was, I think, had the right pacing, but the rest before was a bit rushed a bit. But it's okay, it's fine. I'm still kind of sad and sour about the fact that Marcy and Sasha only got to use their powers in the very last episode and only for a very brief time. That's sad. Also, I read in a tweet afterwards that Matt Brawley confirmed that Sasha is bisexual, and I'm kind of sour about the fact that he didn't make Anne and her a couple in the future. It was a story about friendship, but it could end with them as a couple in the future. That would be no problem. Maybe them hanging out after Marcy left meant them being together a very brief time. That could be. We don't know, but it was definitely no far future thing. Well, it doesn't have to be. It's okay. I personally would have liked that, but it's okay that it didn't happen. And every shipper that shipped any of them knows now that they are just a friends thing. I mean, even after the very last scene that we saw them, they could become a couple thing or even a three-person relationship thing. But I doubt that Matt Brawley would confirm that or say yes to that even. There's one other criticism I have on this episode. It's about the scene where they all say goodbye. And it's Sasha's and Grimes goodbye, because it was just played for comedic, loss, and it was too over the top for me. At least mix comedy with also a little scene of an actual heartfelt goodbye, and then I would have been okay with it, but it was just for comedy, and that was a bit too much for me. It was a bit sad. I thought they would have a much more realistic looking and feeling goodbye. And it was kind of sad to me personally that Marcy didn't hug Andreas, at least briefly. I know why it didn't happen. I know it maybe shouldn't happen, but I'm still sad about it a bit. Because they have been friends, even if just for a very short time and to a certain degree. And there was this whole betraying thing also happening at the same time. So I get it, but it's still a bit sad. I would have enjoyed seeing her going to him and giving him a brief hug and then just nodding and he's smiling and nodding and her leaving then. But okay, I get it. It's okay. He doesn't exactly completely deserve a hug. It's kind of weird that he doesn't die. I thought he would definitely die. But apparently this just hurt a few machines of him and the rest stays intact. Okay. I kind of feel that somebody should have died. Many things feel a bit retconned here, like Anne dying, but they're not dying, and Andreas dying, but they're not dying. A lot of people dying, but they're not dying. At least one death should have happened, and not only the core. The core was obvious. Nobody cares about the core, but a character you actually cared about, at least partly. And Andreas would have been perfect. So it's fine that he lives. I'm happy for him. I hope that one day people will make friends with him again and he will stay a good guy and all that. But for dramatic reasons, I think he should have died. Other than that, this was a nice episode, a very touching episode, very heartfelt episode. Heartfelt goodbyes, at least partly. It was nice to see what happens to the characters later on. And so we got a really nice, big, enormous goodbye that is something that we needed after the series. I hope that the Outlaws will provide something like that as well. But I must admit that I prefer the episode that came before this, All In. I think that felt much, much better than this episode. Even though the sad moments in this episode, they really hit. It was a good ending. I saw other shows that had way worse endings. And no, Star Wars The Forces of Evil was definitely worse than this, but I didn't hate it. Just before you say, oh yeah, Star Wars is, but for me personally, it was okay. Not as good as this though, of course. I think I would have loved it if the whole fighting stuff would have happened in the episode before. And in this very last episode, we would have just have a very long epilogue episode where we see even more about each of their lives. And in the end, Sprig or Anne find a portal, another new way to visit each other's world and to see each other again as adults. That would have been great. Now it's up in the air and probably they will never meet again. And that is very, very sad. Oh, I forgot to say, I'm very happy about Eunin and Olivia confirmed couple. And I loved Sprig's and Poi's new designs. They fit so well. It's beautiful. And overall, just a big yes. Thank you, Matt Brawley, for bringing this world to us and to me especially. Thank you for offering me this ride and giving me so many happy hours and funny hours and also heartfelt hours. I enjoyed them thoroughly and I'm very, very grateful for your series. Thank you for sharing your talent and your story with the world. I added this in very late, but I just wanted to give a small comment on the fact that Anne is apparently gonna be a cosmic guardian when she dies after her death. That's awesome! What the hell? It's cool. It's a cool addition. I like it. It's kind of over the top and all of that, but the whole episode was over the top, so yay. It's a beautiful fate for her, and it fits, I guess. She deserves that. She's a good girl. This series will stay with me for a long time. And I think I will watch it again in the future after some time passed and enjoy the whole journey again. That's a good thing. You can go on the same journey again. Anne and Sprig maybe can't ever be on the same journey again. But we can go on the journey again and start it anew. That's just awesome. And it's sad because I don't want to see them part ways again in the end and not being able to see each other again for at least 10 years. Oh, maybe forever. But that's how it is. That's life. Things change. And that was one of the themes. In the beginning, it was more friendship and love and all of that. But now it was also change and goodbye. The series grew and its themes grew. It's kind of beautiful if you think about it. And sad. I mean, yeah, it's one of the biggest things you learn as an adult. That things change. That everything changes, including you. And that change is inevitable. I need to stop here. It's getting too depressing. Yeah. Happy ending again. No depressing thoughts anymore. Yoo-hoo. Why did this have to end up with existentialism? How about I do a shout-out to my patrons? Shout-out to my patrons! By the way, if you become a $5 plus patron, you can watch a lot of my Amphibia Season 3 watch-alongs. So become a patron. Link is in the first pinned comment and in the description. Big shout-out goes out to my biggest patrons, my heroes, Alex Finch, Monica Redondo, and Vespa. Again, big thanks from all of my heart to Matt Brawley and the whole crew that brought Amphibia to life. What an amazing journey. Thanks for that. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. See you in the next one. Andy out. We'll be right back.